This music, right here.
You're such a liar, man! I can get you whatever you want.
Hello, India. I'm Maitri Ramakrishnan, your girl next door with the best romantic life, which is absolutely not true. Who am I even kidding? But just like Davey, I do have huge romantic expectations. And who do I blame this for? Film and TV. Yeah, lots of expectations. So here I am, reacting to some classic Indian romantic films to see where these expectations came from.
One second. Wait, I love you. I love you. I love you very, very much, man. I love you and...
The blank page, bro! There's nothing on the page. Because it's coming from his heart. Love triangle here. Love triangle, never have I ever. But I think this trope has like the whole like confession of love moment. And we have those with Ben and Davey, which is nice and grand. But I also think in season two, when Paxton says like, I want to be with you. Like, I want you as my girlfriend. We love that. You're in the middle of a wedding. These two are wedding guests right now. They're like pretty like up in the front. They're having a whole conversation. While the vows are happening, you're telling me realistically no one's like, hey, yo, can you like shush? Like, kind of rude. I mean, okay, it's cute. If someone did this at my wedding, this is a very typical meet cute. I feel like Davey didn't have a meet cute. She just like saw Paxton and was like, wow. I think that's kind of canon for Never Have I Ever. I guess though, Dez was a little bit of a meet cute. That was like a, whoa, you're cute. Not a, oh my God, meet cute. I love Omchantyom just because of how like the costuming is. That's probably one of my biggest reasons. Also, like Shah Rukh Khan plays such a like happy-go-lucky character that usually would like kind of piss me off. This music, right here. So good, that's so good. It's so dramatic, but like it makes sense and it's great and. She's so gorgeous. In this movie, Omchantyom, it's a lot about, you know, true love prevailing no matter what, no matter the circumstances, which I'm a sucker for. I think for Davey, with love always prevailing, you sometimes have to do, like, grand gestures. But you know what? Davey does do grand gestures of love. For example, platonic love. When she does her whole cricket dance, even though it was very much so not appropriate and that's not what she should have done to apologize to Anissa. And platonic love is just as important as romantic love. Dude, Shah Rukh Khan's a man. I mean, we all know this, but like, we can't say it enough. He's the man, bro. See, this is, we love it. Banter. We love banter. We do.
You look fine.
And then intense music plays. I wish never have I ever had more dramatic, intense music that randomly starts playing. Obviously, there's parallels between the whole second chance. Because yeah, season three, Ben, Davey, like, oh, let's give this a second shot, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's really fun in film and TV. But I do like the banter. The banter is cute. I love good banter. So that was a lot of fun. I don't know when I'm gonna find someone like these amazing romantic heroes, but unlike me, Davey's love life is definitely not boring. So good for her. Go witness it for one last time on Never Have I Ever, season 4. Which is now streaming.